In this illustration, we'll analyze the expansion of a soap bubble. Here we are given that a soap bubble of radius r and surface tension T is given some charge, and as a result of which its potential becomes V volt. We are required to show that the new radius capital R of soap bubble is given by this equation where P naught is the atmospheric pressure. So here in solution, we analyze the potential, for which we can say if a charge Q is given to the soap bubble, we can write its potential can now be given as V is equals to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught times Q by R. We'll take the radius to be the final radius, because after supplying charge, it will expand. So, if the soap bubble expands to a radius r, in this situation, its outer surface will be experiencing an outward electric pressure, and inside there will be an atmospheric pressure acting on the surface in radially inward direction. Our pressure is scalar, but it will be in inward sense we can consider, and due to surface tension there will be an excess pressure inside. So here we can write after expansion of bubble at radius capital R, the inside air pressure will be, here we can write the inside air pressure to be equals to outside pressure as P naught, which is opposed by the electric pressure, which is given as sigma square by 2 epsilon naught, plus the excess pressure acting is 4T by R. And here we can write the value of sigma is Q by 4 pi R square. And if we substitute the value of Q from this relation, we can see this will be Q by 4 pi. We can substitute as epsilon naught V R divided by R square. So this epsilon naught V by R, the value of sigma. And now, as the final pressure, we are having this. We can write before expansion, the inside pressure was P inside dash, which can be written as only P naught plus 4T by small r, as initially Q charge was not there. So we can write now by gas law, P1V1 is equals to P2V2. As we are assuming the temperature of inside air to be at a constant value, so initially the pressure was P naught plus 4T by small r, and the volume of air bubble was 4 by 3 pi small r cube. Finally, the pressure changes to P naught minus sigma square by 2 epsilon naught plus 4T by r, and the volume is taken as 4 by 3 pi capital R cube. If we simplify this relation by substituting the value of sigma over here, and here you can see if we cross multiply and simplify the relation, this will give us P naught multiplied by R cube minus small r cube plus 4T multiplied by R square minus small r square minus the value of sigma. When you substitute here, this becomes epsilon naught square V square by R square. So the remaining term will be epsilon naught V square R, and that is equals to 0. You can rearrange and you can get this equation, which is the equation we are required to evaluate. Here I have missed this 2 also, which will also be there. You can simplify and verify this result that we are required to prove.